Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Now, as a film and play producer, our next guest has made it her life's work to bring the beauty and complexities of women of color to the page and the screen. And as one of my dearest, dearest friends, and as a best-selling author and speaker, she focuses on helping women heal, heal resentment, and their insecurities to be their best selves. Please welcome my dear friend, Cheryl Polote-Williamson.
Yes.
Welcome.
Yes.
I feel so honored to be here.
Yes.
I'm so grateful to God.
Yes,
for
amen.
I really am.
This is a vision board moment, you told us.
It is absolutely a vision board moment for me. I believe that mindset is everything. So when I decided that I wanted to be on Sister Circle, I placed it on my vision board and I wrote it in my gratitude and intention journal. Every day.
You're gonna take me out, Cheryl.
Yes. And I spoke about it at my house. And Kim said, I know the producer. And I just said, Kim, only God could do something like this.
Oh, wow.
And then it just, I mean, God really blessed me because I came to Atlanta for the Bronze Lens Film Festival, and I made my reservations to leave on Monday, not knowing that I was going to be on Sister Circle, but God knew it.
Yes!
So, He prepared me, so I didn't have to change anything.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And I'm just grateful to see the manifestation of what it means when you really believe and walk out what you write down and you do it with intention. And with the intention, you have to have execution.
Yes.
So when people said, oh, are you ready for the interview? I was ready when I wrote it on the board.
Come on now. All right. Yes. I'm gonna tell you something about Cheryl too. Cheryl will actually send you a text of the mission of the intention of the day, it's almost like she brings her girlfriends along with her on the quest to have the best vision possible. So thank you for. I'm glad I'm one of your friends. I guess that's great for me.
Yes,
took that all the way to Habakkuk, okay?
Vision making plain. But speaking of writing, you are just an amazing writer for screen and stage. And so how important is it for a woman of color to kind of set that precedence and be at the table?
It is important for us to be at the table because we need to have our stories heard. See, when we're not at the table, our stories don't get her.
It's a different narrative.
It's a very different narrative. Mm-hmm. So I believe when we walk in truth and transparency and we share our stories, we help other people heal. And those are the reasons that I write the books that I write, that I involve myself in the projects that I take, because I want the opportunity to bring other people along, other women that look like me, that have been hurt or betrayed or whatever that is, and for us to realize that we can rise again. We don't have to just be held down by our circumstance, and putting it out in books and stage plays and film, we allow other people the ability to be free.
Speaking of which, you debuted your film Illegal Rose yesterday at the Bronze Lens Film Festival, which stars Jasmine Guy. And that's, I mean, first of all, congratulations. But talk to us about this story, and it's about the kidnapping of a 9-year-old immigrant from an immigration camp. Tell us about that and why this story is so important.
I want to say that this moment is powerful for me because of a question you just asked me about sisterhood. This movie was actually written and directed by award-winning Deborah Riley Draper.
Yes.
I was actually invited as a part of this movie. I came just to serve coffee. And because I was willing to serve coffee on set, I ended up an executive producer on the film because I was able to raise the funds for the movie in a small period of time. The movie is important because we get lost thinking that immigration is just about one race of people, but it's not. It is about the Jamaicans, the Bohemians. There are more people in captivity than just the Hispanic community. It is an opportunity and an eye-waking film to let us see how important it is for us to look into immigration and for us to return to a people of kindness and love. So our film is about kindness, it's about love, and Deborah wanted to give the message to the world to let us know that we all can be active. Yes. We all can take a part. Yes. We constantly sit around wondering, well, what is Trina doing? What is Quad doing? Mm-hmm. The question should be, what are you doing?
Ooh, come on.
And that's what the film is about. It's a wake-up call for all of us to realize that we can do something to help. And at the end of the film, we even share information, letting people know how you can be a resource, how you can adopt some of these children. Mm-hmm. And this film is a catalyst for change.
Absolutely. In the film, Jasmine Guy, as a nurse, adopts this little girl or yes. takes her mm-hmm. in, I should say, sponsors mm-hmm. her and her family, and the family's able to come back together. And we learn that you can do that too.
Wow.
So you can
wow.
be part of the change.
We're going to have more with Cheryl Williamson when we return, because this information is very valuable
yes.
and your spirit is even more valuable.
Yes.
Right back.
Absolutely.
Yes. Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We are still here with Cheryl Williamson yes. talking about just all types of yumminess.
Absolutely.
Yes, we are.
So I just want to jump right into this. You talk about soul purpose. You say before we even get into the room in Hollywood or even our own lives, we must obtain our soul purpose. Give me a little bit more about that. And how do we do that?
Mm-hmm. For me to get in touch with my soul purpose, I have to spend time every day in meditation, mm-hmm. in honor and praise. Mm-hmm. And when you realize what your soul purpose is, you walk it out authentically, in excellence, and unapologetically. Mm-hmm. So I live a life of being unapologetic. I do the things that God is calling me to do. Mm-hmm. And I would encourage other people to do the same thing. We shrink when we go in the room because we want to make other people feel comfortable. When we know our soul purpose, then we walk in a place of excellence. We don't live our lives being mediocre mm-hmm. because we realize that there's a calling on our life. It's that thing that keeps us up at night that won't let us go. That's your purpose. Mm-hmm. That's right. Your calling. That's right. You want to leave empty.
Yes, mm. absolutely.
Speaking of leaving empty, you give so much, and you have a nonprofit called Soul Reborn.
Oh, yes.
Talk to us about that.
Yes, Soul Reborn was established to help women who have been hurt through resentment, through unforgiveness. I teach women how to forgive and let go, because see, when you walk in forgiveness, you can live a life of fullness.
Yes.
And so every month we hold workshops on mindset, visioning, wealth management, how to share your stories. I've helped 174 people in 18 months share their stories, become best-selling authors, open businesses, and I like to help women specifically because we suffer so much with low self-esteem and low self-worth, and we feel like we have to get everybody's permission to be who God is calling us to be.
Mm-hmm.
We have to realize that we are enough.
Mm-hmm.
We were born enough. Mm. I want to let people know that you are validated.
Ooh.
You are celebrated. Permission granted to be excellence. Be walking in excellence at all times. That's what Soul Reborn is about.
Yes. Listen, you all are getting a taste of this.
This
is my friend now. And she does these epic Facebook Lives. And she comes in, shares these words, and then says, okay, bye-bye.
Right. If you want more information on how you can get what we're feeling here today, please follow her at Cheryl PW Speaks. That's at Cheryl PW Speaks. Thank you so much for being here.
Yes.
We appreciate you.